Good morning to all. You know, in every work with nature, one receives far more than he seeks. So that's why I'm going to start this video by shooting the beauty of nature. And as you know, in the last video, we have discussed about, you know, the areas of parallelograms with the same base and between same parallels are equal, isn't it? We discussed that in the last video. So isn't it? So we had a discussion about that. So now we can say that areas of parallelograms are, if you consider some parallelograms, their areas can be equal. When their areas can be equal, if you are considering parallelograms with the same base and in between same parallels, then only areas of such parallelograms become equal. Suppose if you consider two parallelograms without same base, you cannot say their areas are equal. And suppose if you are going to consider two parallelograms, their base may be common. If they are not in between same parallels, we cannot say their areas are equal. That means if areas of some parallelograms are equal, then both conditions should satisfy. They are on the same base and they should be in between same parallels. That's a very important topic. You may think that is very silly thing, but you have to give much seriousness. And we had a discussion about the proof also, and I think proof is very simple, and proof also you have to learn. And now through this video we are going to continue the session. Okay, watch this video, learn well, practice your question twice. And you know what is my plan is, we are going to discuss all the concept of this chapter throughout. That means I'm going to discuss all the concept of this chapter throughout first. Before starting solving problems, we are going to discuss throughout the concept, and only we will start the discussion of questions only after discussing all the concept of this chapter. Because as I told you, since this chapter is very short chapter, so let us discuss all the concept together, isn't it? And next concept is, so as I told you, you may understood that if you consider two parallel lines L and M, if you are drawing some parallelogram such a way that all parallelograms base are same and in between same parallel, and I have drawn L and M as parallel lines, and this is a parallelogram ABCD with the base AB, and if you are drawing another parallelogram ABEF, so ABCD is a parallelogram and ABEF is another parallelogram, their base is same. If you are drawing another parallelogram C, you can draw in this way also. See, AB some HF. So these are three parallelogram. What is their specialty? Their base is common and they are in between the same parallel. That means area of this parallelogram is equal to area of this parallelogram is equal to area of this parallelogram. Because they are sharing the same base and between the same parallels, then area should be same. That was the theorem we discussed. And let us go to the next you can consider it as a theorem or a question. And the next one is very important as the first one. Okay, very important. Okay, so this is your next theorem. That means if a triangle and a parallelogram are on the same base and in between same parallels, then prove that area of that triangle will be what? Half of the parallelogram. Once again, focus to the theorem. So what this theorem says, if a triangle is there, no? And a parallelogram. That means this time instead of many parallelograms or instead of two parallelograms, we are considering a triangle and a parallelogram. A single triangle and a single parallelogram. What are the specialities of that triangle and that parallelogram? In the last theorem we have discussed about few parallelograms, but this time I am going to discuss about a single triangle and a single parallelogram. So what is the specialty of that triangle and a parallelogram? They are sharing the same base. They are standing on the same base, and this triangle and parallelogram are standing on the same base, and the same triangle and the parallelogram are between same parallels. Then what is the specialty? If the condition is like that, then area of the triangle will be half of that parallelogram. See, let me draw that figure. That means you have to prove that if you consider, if you consider two parallel lines L and M, I'm going to draw a triangle ABC. Its base is what? AB. Because why I'm going to draw a triangle? Because here, in according to the theorem, we have to consider a triangle and a parallelogram. What is the specialty? And I'm going to draw one parallelogram also. But when you draw a parallelogram, see, when you draw a parallelogram, when you try, let it be some ABCD. That means, now we just see the figure, ABC is a triangle and ABCD is a parallelogram. What is the speciality of this triangle and this parallelogram? ABC is a triangle, you know, and ABCD is a parallelogram. What is the speciality? They are on the same base AB. Which is the base of the triangle? AB. Which is the base of the parallelogram? Same, AB. That means they are on the same base. According to the theorem, we have to consider like that. Because they are on the same base. See, they are on the same base. So we have drawn a figure according to the theorem. And that both should be in between same parallel. See, this triangle is between the parallel lines, this and this. And same parallelogram also between the same parallel lines, this and this. Are you following me? Between doesn't means you can consider a triangle and parallelogram in this way. Between, you may think that in between parallel lines means like this. No, it is not the condition. Between parallel lines means that the upper portion of the triangle should be in the upper parallel line and lower portion of the triangle should be in the lower parallel line and upper portion of the triangle should be on the upper parallel line. And in same in the case of parallelogram also, lower portion of the parallelogram should be in the lower parallel line and upper portion is in the upper parallel line. Here upper portion is not in the upper parallel line. So you cannot draw like this. You have to draw in this way. So if you consider a triangle and a parallelogram in this way, that means on the same base and between same parallel lines, then area of triangle and area of parallelogram is not equal as in the previous case. Area of the triangle will be half of the area of the parallelogram. That we have to prove. If the parallelogram's area is 20, triangle's area will be half of that, 10. If triangle's area is 5, then parallelogram's area will be 10. You may understand. The triangle's area will be half of the parallelogram's area means that parallelogram's area will be double of the triangle's area. You have to prove that. Okay. So in the last theorem, what we have discussed, we have considered a few parallelograms. They are on the same base and between the same parallel lines, then their areas will be equal. But here I am going to consider a triangle and a parallelogram with the same base and between the same parallel lines. Then area of the triangle will be half of the area of the parallelogram. That we have to show it out. That means we have to prove that area of this triangle is half of the area of that parallelogram. Can we prove? As I told you, I am going to prove that area of the triangle will be half of the area of the parallelogram. So in order to prove that, let me consider area of triangle ABC first. I am going to consider area of triangle ABC. Are you following me? Area of triangle ABC. So what is area of triangle ABC? How you can calculate area of triangle ABC? How you can calculate area of a triangle? Heron's formula can be used, but there is no information about the three sides of the triangle. So for the time being, let me use the formula half into base into height. Because this is triangle, area of triangle will be half into B into H. You can use the formula. And half into, which is the base of the triangle? Which is the base of the triangle? Yes, very good. AB. AB is the base. AB is the base. Half into, instead of B, I can substitute as AB. And we have to calculate the value of H. What is H here? What is H here? See, the H is not given. So, since H is not given, H is nothing but the height of the triangle. It is not given. Let me draw a height like this. See, this is going to be the H height of the triangle. Are you following me? So what is H now? What is height of the triangle now? H, isn't it? We mentioned the height of the triangle as H. So instead of H, I am going to write it as H itself because we mentioned the height as H. So half into base into height become half into AB into height. Height we mentioned as H itself. So instead of H, I can write H itself because we mentioned the height as H. You may understood. So keep it there. Without, you are not supposed to disturb it, keep it there. So area of triangle ABC is over. Then which is remaining? We have to calculate area of what? Parallelogram. Area of parallelogram ABCD. Which is the formula for calculating area of parallelogram ABCD? Since it is a parallelogram, formula is B into H. What is base there? In this case, parallelogram's base is AB. AB. And what is height here? Height of the parallelogram is not given. So let me draw a height. See, let me ask you a question. Can I say that height of the parallelogram and height of the triangle are equal? Yes, of course. Why? Because they are in between the same parallel lines. No, then whatever the height of the triangle, that will be same as that of the height of the parallelogram. See, this is the height of the triangle and this is going to be the, see, listen, this is the height of the triangle and this is going to be the height of the parallelogram. Height എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ ഉയരമാണ്. അത് രണ്ട് ഏതിന്റെ ഇടയിലാണുള്ളത്? രണ്ട് parallel lines ന്റെ ഇടയിലല്ലേ ഈ ട്രയാങ്കിളും പാരലോഗ്രാമും ഉള്ളത്. അപ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾ ഒന്ന് ആലോചിച്ച് നോക്കി, രണ്ട് parallel lines ന്റെ ഇടയിൽ എവിടെ എവിടെ നോക്കിയാലും height എന്തായിരിക്കും? Same. You know, in between parallel lines height should be same in anywhere. That means height of the triangle and height of the parallelogram should be equal. No, why? Because triangle and parallelogram standing in between the same parallel lines. You know that height of the parallel lines anywhere are equal. So height of the triangle should be equal to height of the parallelogram. No. Yes. So what we can write instead of h, we can write instead of height of the parallelogram, we can write the height of the triangle because both should be equal. So instead of h, I am going to write h itself because h is nothing but the height of the triangle. That will be same as that of the height of the parallelogram. So this will be AB into h itself. And you can write the reason in bracket. Why? What is the reason? We know that height of triangle is equal to height of what? Parallelogram. Why? Why it is so? Because they are in between same parallels. They are in between same parallels. That's why their height should be always equal. So area of the parallelogram formula is B into H. B is nothing but AB. And height of the parallelogram is equal to the height of the triangle. So we can write H as H itself because we mentioned the height of the triangle as H itself. So we understood that much. You may understood, isn't it? And now we just see. Now we just compare both area. So let me start from area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC. Let me start from area of triangle ABC. What was area of triangle ABC? Half into AB into H, no? Half into AB into H, no? So I'm going to write it as half into, instead of AB into H, what was, this is AB into H, no? What was AB into H? AB into H is nothing but C. AB into H. See, AB into H. What was AB into H? Area of parallelogram ABCD. So instead of AB into H, can I write area of parallelogram ABCD? Not understood? See, I calculated area of triangle. I calculated area of parallelogram. You may understood. So height of the triangle is very simple. Maybe while calculating height of the parallelogram, you may feel some doubt. So let me, for the better clarification, let me explain once again. The parallelogram's area formula is B into H. Base is nothing but AB. And height of the parallelogram is equal to height of the triangle in this case. Why? Because they are standing in between the same parallel lines. So height in between the parallel lines anywhere are equal. So instead of H, we can write height of the triangle also because but both triangle and parallelogram are in between the same parallel lines. So what is the height of the triangle? That is H itself. So that's why I write it as AB into H. So after calculating area of triangle ABC and area of parallelogram ABCD, now I'm going to compare. So let me, in order to compare, let me start from area of triangle ABC once again. What was area of triangle ABC? Half into AB into H. So write half into AB into H. And half as it is, you can write down. And instead of AB into H, what was AB into H? See, AB into H ആണല്ലോ ഇവിടെ ഉള്ളത്. AB into H എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ ഇതല്ല AB into H, ഇതല്ല AB into H. ഈ AB into H എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ എന്താണ്? ഏരിയ ഓഫ് പാർലോഗ്രാം എ ബി സി ഡി അല്ലേ. ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് ഇൻസ്റ്റെഡ് ഓഫ് എ ബി ഇൻഡ് എച്ച് യു ക്യാൻ റീപ്ലേസ് ബൈ ഏരിയ ഓഫ് പാർലോഗ്രാം എ ബി സി ഡി. നൗ വി ജസ്റ്റ് സീ വാട്ട് യു ഹാവ് സീൻ. ഏരിയ ഓഫ് ട്രയാങ്കിൾ എ ബി സി വിൽ ബി ഹാഫ് ഓഫ് ദ ഏരിയ ഓഫ് പാർലോഗ്രാം. സോ ഹെൻസ് ദ പ്രൂഫ്. നോ, സീ, ഏരിയ ഓഫ് ട്രയാങ്കിൾ എ ബി സി ഈസ് ഹാഫ് ഓഫ് ഏരിയ ഓഫ് പാർലോഗ്രാം. ദാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ്സെൽഫ് വി ഹാവ് ടു പ്രൂവ്. We have to prove that area of triangle ABC is, area of a triangle is nothing but half of the area of the parallelogram. That we have to prove. We already proved. So that means area of triangle will be half of the area of parallelogram. Hence the proof. So when area of triangle will be half of the area of the parallelogram, if they are on the same base and they are in between the same parallel lines. So that discussion over. You may understood that theorem. You know, this is very very simple theorem. Only the logic is we have to draw to a triangle and a parallelogram as in such that they are sharing the same base and they are in between the same parallel lines, and then we have to calculate the area of triangle by using half into BH formula. We have to calculate area of parallelogram by using B into H, but in this case height should be same because they are in between the same parallel lines. That logic you have to use, that much only, and all the remaining things are equal. You have to give importance to this theorem. And so I'm going to wind up this video session because in the next video session I am going to discuss another
theorem. So this is another theorem, another theorem. So after learning this theorem, I will upload another video that describes another theorem. Okay, and wish you very good learning. Please learn it seriously. Don't consider it as a very silly thing. And you know, let me tell you one thing. If you are start considering a mathematics concept as a very simple thing, that is going to be a great mistake. You know why? You have to give importance to each and every concept in maths. Are you following me? So, goodbye.